basically, I came here from Italy in 1979 to work in films. I didn't speak English. I started to listen to tapes, videotapes, audio tapes from great motivators. After that, I tried to get an agent. But through the years, I guess did not work well. I started feeding pigeons about 30 years ago. I found an injured pigeon that was hit by a car, and I took the bird home, and this pigeon changed my life. I kept him in a little box, and after a few weeks he was feeling better, and then I let him go, and I realized that he would come back. He would come back a few times a week to eat the food, and came to the window, and then he would get inside, and with food be there, and go and come back. I got attached to the animal, so I bought him a bigger cage and took care of him for a few weeks. And what happened was that this pigeon opened my heart so much that I started feeding the other birds in the city, rescue them, and feeding other animals like skunks, possums, raccoons, homeless cats, homeless dogs, you know, but basically pigeons. It cost me almost like almost $10 a day. There was a time I was homeless, and I would find a way. I would find a way to feed them whatever I could. I have a different awakening right now than I had when I came here from Italy. So if I see somebody hurting them, I put myself, I would say, in the line of fire. A few times people were trapping them, and I would intervene to free them, or if anybody would shoot at them, or I rebel, and I put myself in trouble for them. Every day, from where I live, with my shopping cart, I go back where I used to live, and I feed them every day. Every day. Every day I go there, and I feed them. And they're waiting for me. And they would hang around until I fed them. I had to leave the house because there was a roommate that owned the house and passed away. So the house had to be sold. When I moved, they would follow me on the corner. So now I feed them on the corner of that where I used to live.
Hi baby, my baby, one of my babies. When I go up in the mountains, they're gonna follow me, and I know they will follow me. So that's why from here, we're going to go up there. See, they follow me up there. They're waiting for me up there. That's where we're going right now. I have the hot dogs. I have the hot dogs for the seagulls, and I have peanuts for the squirrels.
There's also a city ordinance that you're supposed not to feed birds in the city of Los Angeles. And I know the law a little bit, but I love them so much that I do get in trouble. My self-employed is that sometimes I'm like part-time investigator, sometimes I train people. See, I also was Mr. South Italy. I train people to be in shape. Sometimes I teach Italian, sometimes I teach exercise, or sometimes I help other people to do things in their home. So that's the way I basically make the money to feed the animals.
Look at the seagull are coming now. The seagull are eager to be fed. My babies over there. My baby. That's my baby. That's my baby seagull. With his leg a little upset. That's my baby. That's my baby. He used to come at the house and I used to give him a hot dog at the house. This has been my life for the last 30 years. And I love them. I would give my life for them. Because they opened my heart to so much love. And they opened my heart so much that now I see everybody that is looking at me. That's how I became, by just feeding the pigeons. You have to stop smoking. Look at me. Look at me. Say to yourself, I'm going to stop smoking. Say it.
I'll stop smoking.
I give you money every day. I want you to stop smoking.
Okay.
I don't want to see you dying of cancer.
All right.
Okay?
All right.
Cigarettes, whether it's cigarettes or marijuana, it's poison. It will kill you.
I see a bee in the street or in the middle of the street. I take a dollar bill for myself. I go down in the street and I take the bee in the green side or on the side. I put the bee on safe. That could be a fly, could be anything.
Even if I don't have money, I feed them. Matter of fact, I don't even have a car. But I love them so much.
I would like whoever is watching this video to be more compassionate, more understanding. Animals, they don't have the brain that we have. We have the brain of understanding why we are here, why they are here. If you don't like them, don't kill them, don't poison them. Just go your way. I love all animals and even the human race. Love to life. Love to all things. Love to you who love.